The sky is the limit, and only you can limit how high you fly. Parents, grandparents, it's a bittersweet moment. I know, I can personally relate. Having been in your shoes just 2 short years ago, it's hard to see them grow up, but as we all know, we can't slow down time. And if we're truthful about it, we wouldn't want to, even if we could. Yes, the high school will push them to be more responsible and independent, but parents, it's okay to remind them where they reside and still paying the bills. The UA grades, I want you to do something for me. I want you to look around and find your family. Notice I said family, not just parents. You owe a great deal of gratitude to the people in front of you for being able to be sitting here tonight. Your family has been there for you for the last 14 years, and they'll be there for you when no one else can or will. So please, don't ever take that for granted. Also, if a teacher has made a lasting impression on you, and I have no doubt there's probably several that has, please let them know how much you appreciate them before you leave Dibrell. They poured everything they could to prepare you for the next chapter in your life. In closing, on behalf of Dibrell School and the Warren County Board of Education, we congratulate you and wish you all the best in whatever your future holds. We know you're going to do great things. Last but not least, once a Bobcat, always a Bobcat.
Thank you, Mr. Caldwell. At this time, Mr. Lever will be presenting and recognizing our honorable and perfect attendance students.
All right, good evening. Thank you for coming tonight. I'm going to read out the names of the 8th grade honor roll students as of this day. Honor roll, when I read your name, please stand up. Honor roll, Katie Batchelor. Honor roll, Sarah Byron. Honor roll, Ainsley Rick. Honor roll, Dayan Esparza. Honor roll, Sarah Ebersol. Honor roll, Lisa Sosa. Honor roll, Dayani Franco. Honor roll, Rodrigo Gonzalez. Honor roll, Aaliyah Gurley. Honor roll, Ariana Kirby. Honor roll, Jenna Mullins. Honor roll, Annabelle O'Neill. Honor roll, Maxwell Holmes. Honor roll, Delilah Preston. Honor roll, Alejandra Torres. Honor roll, Ruth Valesco. Honor roll, Cody Wood. Honor roll, Colton Wood. Honor roll, Braden Whiteacre. Thank you, Mega City. And we have one of the hardest awards to win, in my opinion, is the Perfect Attendance Award. And we have one single student. Alana Torres. Perfect attendance. Thank you very much. Next, we will do the presentation of the superlatives with our special guests.
A little bit about the history of Dibrell and my family and how those two intertwine. In 1901, my grandfather, Isaac Dibrell, helped to secure a charter for Dibrell College. He was a strong believer in education and in academic excellence. In 1902, that college began. It ran for 20 years. Many young women and men graduated from Dibrell College, which was a two-year college, much like Motlow in Memphis is today. Those graduates went out and made a difference in the world. They made a difference in our community. They made a difference in our state, and some of them even in our nation. In 1923, Dibrell High School was established. The Dibrell family continued having hands-on at Dibrell High School. The high school was here for 46 years. Several of my aunts, my grandfather's daughters, taught here for many, many years. I graduated from Dibrell High School, as did several of my cousins. The Dibrell family was very involved in Dibrell High School. In 1970, Dibrell became an elementary school and has been so now, get this, for 53 years. Lots of graduates, eighth grade graduates from Dibrell Elementary School, and they've gone on and made their mark in the world. Class of 2023, you are part of a 120-year legacy, and we wish you Dibrell. We know that you will go on and make a difference in this community, in this state, and some of you even in this nation. And you'll always be a member of the graduating class of Dibrell. So now, on behalf of the Dibrell family, I am pleased and so honored to present the 2023 Dibrell Academic Excellence Award to Ms. Jenna Mullins.
Governor's Science Award is Debbie Glenn.
Debbie Holmes and her family usually give this award. It is her grandfather in memory of him, and they were unable to be here tonight. But we are all proud to present the Herman Cantrell Jr. Science Award goes to Roy Colton Wood. And the award for the girl goes to Diana Esparza.
Thank you. Good evening. Congratulations to all the graduates. It's an honor to be able to present the most improved student award. This year's award goes to Hayden Eads.
Thank you.
Well, we're thankful to be here tonight to see our young graduate. It's been a wonderful year. We've enjoyed every athletic event that has come about. And for the Trinity Bates Athletic of the Year, it's Katie Mitchell.
Diana Franco.
Aaliyah Durbin,
Kirby.
takes a lot of practice. All right, this next award is for Mr. and Mrs. Dibrell. Mr. Dibrell is Max Holmes. Mrs. Dibrell is Ainsley Gray.
Some of you in RTI math and kindergarten. as your principal, I can't help but be proud of what you've accomplished to get to this point today. You've faced challenges and you've overcome them. You've experienced new friendships, and you've worked hard to move on to the next phase of your life in high school, and dreaming of the endless possibilities and choices that you will make about your future careers. Robert Frost wrote The Road Not Taken, and it's an ambiguous poem that allows the reader to think about choices in life, whether to go with the mainstream or go it alone. And if life is a journey, this poem highlights those times in life when a decision has to be made and you have plenty to make. The Road Not Taken. Two roads diverged in the yellow wood. And sorry, I could not travel both. And big one traveler, long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could, to where it went in the undergrowth. Then took the other as just as fair, and heaven perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and long and bare. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. And both that morning equally played, in leaves no step and trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yet knowing how ways lead to play, I doubted if I ever should come back. I shall be telling this with a sign, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by. And that has made all the difference. So graduates, whatever path you choose to take in life, take a moment as you make that decision. You have a lot of decisions to make. Weigh your choices. And remember that if you believe in yourself, even when no one else will, you can achieve it if you are determined to get to the end of the journey that the road of life you choose to take will lead you to fulfill your goals. You don't have to follow anyone else's path, no matter what your friends are doing, no matter what your family wants you to do. Hopefully you'll listen to your family a little bit. You know. But if the one less traveled is the path that's best for you, make it your path. You only have to believe it in yourself to make your dreams and your goals come true. And we all look forward to hearing from you in the future. It's been nice to see some of our former students here today to come celebrate you. We want you to come back. We want to see all the wonderful things that you will achieve, because we know you will. We're so proud of our dear Wildcats that are before us tonight as they achieve yet another milestone in their educational journey and move on from the 8th grade to the high school. Standing before us today, we have to offer congratulations to the future graduation class of 2027. But right now you're the class of 2023. But you're going to make it to the class of 2027. So at this time, it is with great pride that I get to recognize you as graduates. So I'm going to ask this honors class to please stand. Casey Davis. Let's give one last round of applause for Ms. Runner's class. And may you see her. Now I ask Mr. Leffler's class to please stand. Abigail Hancock. Hannah Mitchell.
Oh,
parents allow. And we'll have a lockdown until 10, and he will be able to come by the gym and pick them up at 10 o'clock. And as you go out to the hallway, receiving as you leave, some refreshments, some cupcakes and cookies have been provided for families to enjoy. We're very thankful for the hard work of our teachers and Ms. Erica and all of the parents who helped make tonight possible. But the hard work of each one of these students in front of us is what got them here. We're very proud of them. So I'm going to ask you to please stand.